You have to read the lesson, prose lesson 1, supplementary road not taken poem with the video link which is sent to you, and you can have your textbook in hand to go through all these things. And tomorrow you have to get ready to write a test on it for 25 marks. I will send you the question. You have to get ready with the thing. Now I am going to teach you the art of letter writing. You all know that letter writing is an essential skill. And this letter is going to help you out in your board examination. Like, it is going to provide you the maximum marks. Do you agree with me, children? The letter which you are going to write is going to give you maximum marks. You will get 8 marks or 5 marks over there. And if your letter is going to be completely good, full marks. So letter writing is an art, and this comes under writing part, section B in your question paper. Section B, where you have writing and grammar skills. Despite the prevalence of email and text messages, letter continue to remain one of the most important and popular means of communication. Do you agree with this thing, children? Do you agree with this statement? Despite the prevalence of email and text messages, letter continue to remain one of the most important and popular means of communication. From the beginning, that is from the days till now, like, letter writing has its own essence. And you people, like, you will have a part over there in your question paper where you have to be very clear of what you are going to write. We are going to see the format of formal letter today. And many times in 8th standard also I have taught you how to write a formal letter. Formal letter, I am going to discuss with you point wise. First point is, you have to be clear with the sender's address. What is the first point? Sender's address. Write sender's address here. Never put your name here. Be clear with this. Never put your name here. This is the thing you have to follow in your exam paper when you are going to write your board examination. You are not supposed to write your name. But now when you are going to write in your composition notebook, you can write your name. Write sender's address here. Never put your name here. This you should follow only in your board examination paper. After the sender's address, the next thing to be followed is, I have given you here in points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 points. You have to be careful about 6 points. The next thing which you have to include is date. Followed by the sender's address, next you have dates. The date appears directly below the address after leaving a line. I have given things in a clear way, children. The date appears directly below the address after leaving a line. Next to the sender's address, you have to leave a line. Then you have to write the date. Followed by that, the receiver's designation and address. The person who is going to receive your address. If they have a good designation, if you are going to write it to your principal or if you are going to write it to some higher authorities, it is compulsory to mention their designation and address over there. Designation followed by address. Followed by that, you have subject of the letter. What is the subject of the letter? This, you can also call this as the body of the letter, where you are going to discuss the content. For what you are going to write the letter. What is the reason of writing this letter? And be very clear, subject statement should not be lengthy. Your subject should be in a line. Your subject should be in a line or two lines. Not more than that. It should not be lengthy. Your subject should have 5 to 8 words or 8 to 10 words. Not more than that. Your subject statement should not be lengthy. Followed by this subject only you have salutation. Am I clear? Followed by the subject you have salutation. What is this salutation, children? Where you will salute the receiver as respected ma'am, respected sir. You will give a salutation, no? That should be followed with the subject. And next you have a complementary clause. Complementary clause, you all know what is called complementary clause. Like yours truly, yours faithfully, you will write your name there. Here is the format of formal letter with 6 points to have it in your mind. Again, I give you the 6 points over here. Sender's address, followed by the sender's address, leave a line and give the date. And next to the date, receiver's designation and address should come. Followed by the receiver's address, there should be the subject. What should be there? The subject should be there. And next to that you have salutation. The way you will just salute them as respected, ma'am, sir, like that. And if it is going to be informal letter, you can give it like dear ma'am or sir, like that you can write. Next, complimentary clause. Complimentary clause, the final concluding part of the letter where you are going to give your name with yours truly and friendly. In the next slide, this is a very important slide, children. Okay, you can pause over here. You can note down the points. As I discussed with you, the 6 points, you can take it down in your notebook. This you can take it down in your notebook, in your classwork notebook with date. No problem. Take it down in your classwork notebook with date. All the 6 points should be taken down. Give the heading as format of formal letter. Am I clear? Give today's date. Give the heading as format of formal letter. Note down the points one after the other. First point, second point, third point, fourth point, fifth point and sixth point. Next to the point, I have given you some description over there. Even that you can note down. Do it with care, children, because letter is going to play a vital role in your board examination paper. The way you present your letter should be good. It will help you to get good marks. So be thorough with this format of formal letter. Now it will be better for you to note down in your classwork notebook with the date. And as I have insisted you are just going to follow it in your classwork notebook with the date. No need to divide the notebook, no need to turn the notebook, nothing should be done. Just write it with as you are going to follow with the date. Heading is important, children. Heading is something important. Heading will make you to identify the thing which you are going to write. Even this you can note down. Give the side heading as steps to be followed. Make a note of it, steps to be followed. The first important point of writing a letter is, when you write a letter, the whole content of the letter should be to the left margin. Where usually we start writing in a notebook, we will have a left margin. Left margin line do we have or not? The whole content of the letter should be with the left margin. Nothing should be taken to the right margin. Everything with the left margin. The sender's address, date, receiver's address, salutation, subject, complimentary clause. The whole content of the letter should be to the left margin. That is the reason why I have given you this arrow mark. The whole content of the letter should be where, children? It should be with the left margin. Next, there is some important thing to discuss. When we talk about the body of the letter, you can write your letter like this. It will give you a good presentation. The letter will be divided into three things. Like first, the introductory part, body of the letter. Body of the letter, the paragraphs which you are going to write. First, a line of introduction, why you are writing the letter. Then informative para, what is the reason? Introduce yourself, why you are writing. Informative para, you just convey the information why you have written this letter. Conclusion. Conclusion, you will say, no, looking forward for a good reply, best reply. And we are hoping to get a positive reply from you. That is called conclusion. Introduction, introduce yourself and take your point to the notice of the particular people and write the informative paragraph of what you need, what is the reason of writing the letter. You can discuss the idea here in informative para. Finally, in conclusion, This conclusion is expressed used to express your hope. Now we will see a detailed thing about it. Body of the letter, after the subject which you are going to write, after the subject, introduction. Don't give side heading, children. Be very clear. Don't give side headings. I don't need side headings. Body of the letter, I don't need side headings over there. Introduction, informative para, conclusion, no. Introduction, it describes the purpose of writing. Why you are writing such letter? Informative para, it is going to convey the message why the letter is written. Describes the purpose of writing, conveys the message why the letter is written. Conclusion, ending the letter with a hope, or you can give a comment over there, or a request can be given over there. Again, I tell you, don't give side headings. Be very clear. Don't give side headings. No introduction. But the introductory part should be there. No heading as introduction should come. No informative para. No side heading. No conclusion. No side headings. But all these things should be present. How we are going to describe the purpose, how we are going to convey the message, and how we are going to end the letter with the hope should be there. Is it clear for everyone? And complimentary clause, here I have an important thing for you. In complimentary clause, you are sincerely, faithfully, truly, we will write. Never use apostrophe in yours. Often I insist you regarding this, never use apostrophe in yours. Am I clear? No apostrophe should be used in yours. So this is the way you are going to write the formal letter. Now this is what is given in your textbook. Address of the sender and receiver, the salutation, body of the letter, closing phrases and signature. Here there is a model for you. Your address, date, the addressees. Addressees means the receiver's address, and subject you can give here. Subject, dear sir or respected sir you can write. Dear sir or respected sir. Next to that you will have your body of the letter. You are going to write the purpose, going to convey the message, and finally you are going to conclude the letter. Yours, here you can see yours is not having an apostrophe over here. This model I have taken it from your textbook, from prose lesson 1. The whole content of the letter should be with the left margin. Nothing should be taken to the right margin. Whole content of the letter to be with the left margin. Body of the letter should go for 6 or 7 lines. Introduce the purpose of writing. Example, I will tell you. I would like to bring it to your kind notice that, convey the message and come to the concluding part of it, looking forward for a positive reply from you. Things like that. You can end it. After getting a clear understanding of all these things, you can start writing the letter. I'll give you the question. Okay, the question I will give you, like the question to write a letter tomorrow, you can start writing a letter. But when you write a letter, keep all this thing in your mind, which is going to help you out. What is the thing I have taught you today, children? Format of formal letter which you are going to write. Is it clear for everyone? So today's session is over. Meet you in next session. Tomorrow you'll have a test in English for 25 marks from prose lesson 1, poem 1, supplementary 1. Question will be sent to you. Get ready to write the test. Have your views in hand, and you can also have your textbook in hand. Go through the views, video links which are sent to you. Get a clear understanding of prose lesson, poem and supplementary. Whereas when you write the test, you will feel happy over there. Thank you, children. See you